Good morning, church. Good morning, church. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it. Good morning, church. Good morning from the north and the south to the east and the west to those are online. Good morning, church. We are so grateful that we're able to come into the house of God, be it virtual or in person, just to give Him thanks and praise for what He has done for us. We are so excited that He's a healer, that He's a keeper, that He's a way maker this morning. So I welcome you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit to one more time to worship our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. My name is Reverend Dr. Tori Butler. It's my honor and privilege to be the pastor of this house. And we are so grateful and glad that you took time out of your schedule to come to Asbury Town Neck, again, be it physically or virtually this morning, just to say, God, here we are to worship. At this time, I want to invite everyone just to get into a position of silence and reverence. We want to take a moment of silence in remembrance of September 11th. This is the 21st anniversary of what happened that day, and we want to make sure that we honor those who have gone on to glory, those who are still fighting for services. We just take a moment to remember them. Amen. Thank you. I turn it over to our Johnson Mail chorus to kick off our worship experience, because I know that there is power coming from these anointed, gifted men of God. Let's prepare our hearts and minds to worship our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ.
Oh, come on. You can do better than that. Give God some praise. Come on. Praise the Lord, because He brought you from a mighty long way. Come on, stand to your feet and help us praise the Lord this morning. You're going to get your blessing if all you got to do is reach up and get it.
I ain't going nowhere until you bless me. I ain't going nowhere until you bless me. Without your blessing, Lord, I can't make it at all. Please, please, please bless me. I'm gonna stay right here until you bless me. I'm gonna stay right here until you bless me. Without your blessing, Lord, I can't leave. Please, 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 bless me.
I got faith in you.
I got faith in you.
And I trust you too.
And I trust you too.
Gonna sit and wait.
Gonna sit and wait.
'Cause you're never too late.
'Cause you're never too late.
I'm not gonna let you go until you
bless me.
I'm not gonna let you go until you bless me.
Hey,
without your blessing, Lord, I can't make it at all. Please,
please, please, please, please bless me.
'Cause I got faith in you.
I got faith in you.
And I trust you too.
And I trust you.
Gonna sit and wait.
Gonna sit and wait.
'Cause you're never too late.
'Cause you're never too late.
Please, Lord.
Please, please, please.
Mm-hmm.
Bless me.
Come on, Jesus.
Bless me.
Come on, Jesus.
Bless me.
If you will.
Bless me.
Do it for me right now.
Bless me.
Do it, Jesus.
Oh, bless me. bless me.
I'm not gonna let you go.
Bless me.
I'm not gonna let you go.
Oh, bless me.
Until you bless my soul.
Bless me.
Until you bless our soul.
Oh, bless me.
I wonder, would you bless my family?
Bless me.
I wonder, would you bless my home?
Oh, bless me.
We need you to bless this choir.
Oh, bless
to
me.
To keep us going on.
Oh, bless me.
Each and every day.
Oh, bless
and
me.
And every hour on the hour.
Oh, bless
each
me.
Each and every minute.
Oh, bless
and
me.
And each and every second.
Oh, bless me.
I want to walk blessed.
Oh, bless me.
I want to talk blessed.
Oh, bless me.
Would you bless our tongues?
Bless me.
Each and every one.
Bless me.
We need you, Jesus.
Bless me.
We need you, Jesus.
Bless me. Bless me.
If you will.
Bless me.
Do it, Jesus.
Bless me.
Cause I got faith in you.
I got faith in you.
And I trust you too.
And I trust you too.
Gonna sit.
You're never too late.
Please, Lord.
Please.
Uh-huh.
Bless me.
Hallelujah. God, will you bless our souls? Look into Jesus. Father God, Lord Jesus, we come to you right now, God, just to say thank you.
Thank you.
Oh, Heavenly Father, we thank you for this day. We thank you for keeping us through the night while we slumbered and rising us up, God, early this morning, clothed in our right mind with another chance just to praise you, God. God, we thank you for your love. Now, God, we ask you to go with the sick. Lord, go into the hospitals, go into the nursing homes. God, we ask you to bless those who have addictions. Lord, go with them and be with them and let them know that they can still depend on you. Now, Heavenly Father, we want to thank you for just the opportunity to be in this place to give you worship one more time. God, we just thank you for putting in our hearts the melodies on our lips, the songs in our hearts of praise to praise you. Now, God, we ask you to stop by Asbury Town Neck this morning and to be with our pastor. God, she has a word that you gave to us. And God, we just ask you to give her your best today so she can give you her best. Hallelujah. God, we thank you. We love you. We praise you. And we bless your holy name. It's in the name of Jesus that I pray this prayer. And my soul says amen.
Amen.
I still
remember.
what you've done.
What you've done for me.
Lord, what you've done.
What you've done for me.
When I was sick.
Oh, Lord.
And the doctor said I couldn't get well.
I still remember.
You heal my body, Lord. You've done.
What you done for me.
Oh, Lord.
Oh, Lord.
Lord,
I still remember.
Oh, Father.
Oh, Lord.
Lord, I still
remember.
Oh, Lord.
Oh, Lord.
Lord,
what you done for me.
When I was sick.
Oh, Lord.
And the doctor said I couldn't get well.
Remember.
Now you heal my body, Lord.
Oh,
what you done?
What you done for me?
What you done?
What you done for me?
What you done?
What you done for me?
Lord, what you done?
What you done for me?
There was a woman.
What you done for me?
With an issue of blood, 10 long years.
What you done?
You came
for
looking
me?
For Jesus. And if I could touch the hem of his garment, I know I would be made whole.
What you done for me?
What you done?
What you done for me?
Lord, what you done?
What you done for me?
Lord, what you done?
Done for me?
Oh, what you done?
What you done for me?
Oh, what you done? For me,
for me.
What you done for me.
For me.
You don't know my story.
What you done?
But I'm gonna tell you.
For me.
God is a good God.
What you done?
And you put your faith in him.
For me.
Oh, there was a woman.
What you done?
With an issue of blood.
For me.
10 long years.
What you done?
She came running to Jesus.
For me.
And if I could only touch the hem of his garment. I know I'll be made whole.
What you done?
Oh, Lord.
For me.
Oh, what you done?
What you done?
For me.
For me.
What you done?
What you done?
Done for me.
For me.
What you done? What you done?
What you done?
Done for me.
For me.
Oh, what you done?
What you done?
Done for me.
For me.
There was the story.
What you done?
That I need to tell you.
For me.
Over in Vietnam.
What you done?
God brought me back.
For me.
I'm gonna give him my praise.
What you done?
Every hour of the day.
For me.
Cause that is.
What you done?
That's my story.
For me.
I said that is. That's my story. That's what you done.
What you done?
Yeah, for me.
For
oh,
me.
What you done?
What you done for me?
Yes. You don't know my story. My story. I said, God is a good God. He'll bring you through if you just trust him.
Come on now.
And believe in him.
Amen. Let's not forget. Let's always remember what God has done for us. Somebody say amen up in the house. Amen, amen. When you remember how God brought you through the past, it'll help you get through the present. Somebody, anybody believe that? Amen. Amen, amen. 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 Well, we greet you with Jesus' joy this morning, again, physically here in the church and to our family online. Today, we also celebrate United Women in Faith anniversary, previously known as United Methodist Women. And so at this time, I'd like to invite Pat Clark, who will give us a few words on this occasion. Amen. Amen. Amen.
To Dr. Torrey and others who are participating in today's service, good morning. To those of you whom are seated, as well as those whom are watching virtually, good morning to you. I am Pat Clark, and I am charged with the responsibility of saying a few things via our president, whom is presently in the hospital. Today would have been an anniversary for Women of Faith, previously known as United Methodist Women. I would ask, please, that those of you who are members, please stand for our purpose and statement. You will hear several times today, Women of Faith, previously known as United Methodist Women. We are a community of women whose purpose is to know God and to experience freedom as whole persons through Jesus Christ, to develop a creative, supportive fellowship, and to expand concepts of mission through participation in the global ministries of the church. Our mission statement is that United Women in Faith seek to connect and nurture women through Christian spiritual formation, leadership development, creative fellowship, and education so that they can inspire, influence, and impact local and global communities. United Women in Faith is the organization which announced in March of 2022 to have the name change. The move is part of a refreshing organization that includes a new logo. There are new and improved programs to nurture current members and welcome new women to join to put their love in action on behalf of women, children, and youth. The new name also aims to welcome current members whose local churches may choose to disaffiliate from the United Methodist Church, as well as women of other faith traditions who want to join. United Women in Faith focuses on mission, children, and youth. Thank you, ladies. You may sit. So a few of the things that the organization has done, although COVID stopped some of what we were able to do through a lack of gathering. So our unit supported the Angel Tree. We had that famous fish fry that we love to get away from, but you seem to really like. We blessed our graduates of Asbury Town Neck with a graduation brunch. And to those of you who see us as little old ladies, understand that there are new things on the scene. So these little old ladies are now having younger ladies to join, part of our objective. And if you didn't think we're just old in action, ask Michelle, the person who does the exercise. So we continue to support programs in the United States and around the world that benefit, again, women, children, and youth. So that there are five parts of mission giving. We pledge to mission. We have a special mission recognition. We have a gift to mission, a gift in memory, and world thank offering. So all of our money is designated to a specific mission. These tools offer an excellent opportunity to deepen spirituality and to broaden the understanding of mission work. We're currently looking for Christian women to put their faith into practice and action. The officers that we presently have are President Barbara Hawthorne, Vice President Grace Marie Watkins, Secretary Elisa Somerville, thank you, Elisa, one of our younger women who joined, Treasurer Brenda Watkins, and Nominations Chair, yours truly. So I ask that you look for things that we're doing. Please call any one of the officers if you have questions or concerns. And thank you, Dr. Torrey, for permitting us to have this brief presentation.
Church, throughout life, you take time out for everything else. You gotta take time out for Jesus sometimes. And what you gotta do is you gotta sit down and talk to him, because he will answer prayer. How many out there know he will answer prayer? Thank you. Now let us
have a little talk with Jesus.
And let us
tell him all about our struggle.
He will
hear our faintest cry.
And he will answer
by and by.
Well, when you feel
a little prayer will turn it,
then you'll know.
From heaven.
everything you're going through.
He'll make it all right.
Just give it to Jesus.
He'll make it all right.
If your heart is heavy laden,
he'll make it all right.
Turn it over to Jesus.
He'll make it all right.
He'll fix you every day. Your troubles.
Before I just give a few of the business announcements this morning, you know, our hearts are gone out to a faithful member of our church, Miss Betty Grimes, who went home to be with the Lord. And I just want to speak just a second to that, just to say that's what we're counting on, guys. That's what all this is about. That when we leave here, come on, somebody, we're going to wake up in his presence. So we don't grieve like the world, although on an earthly standpoint, we hurt. Amen. But we're counting on it. Are you guys counting? I'm counting on it. That when I leave here, I'm going to be in the presence of the Lord. Amen. 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 So let's continue to keep her family and her close friends in prayer this morning. Well, I just want to say praise the Lord. And we thank Patricia Pat Clark for giving us the occasion for this annual
anniversary that we celebrate every year. And for Barbara Hawthorne, for her leadership, and for all the Town Neck women, for their faithful work. I know you guys do it outside of the church, but also for your faithful work here at Asbury Town Neck. So we want to love on you and just say thank you for all of the faithful service that you do for this branch of Zion. I also want to say today is Grandparents' Day. If you didn't know that, Grandma and Grandpa shouldn't have to cook today. Come on, somebody. Amen, amen. The pastor mentioned about acknowledging 9/11. And this month is Prostate Awareness, World Alzheimer's a month. So just keep all of those particular events for the month in your mind. Amen. Amen. Well, speaking of also showing love and community, we want to thank all of you that supported ACAN last Thursday by attending Chick-fil-A and getting your chicken sandwich. Come on, somebody. They got the best lemonade. Amen. Amen. So we thank you, and I'm sure that when it's time for them to give the announcements, they'll let us know how close they were or if they met their goal for the day. We also want to thank those of you that participated in the blood drive at Pastor Sedina, and also Freetown Community Day. So I just want to say that. Well, just a general reminder about a business thing that we have to take care of. We have a church council meeting that's going to take place this Tuesday, a couple days from now. It'll be at 6:30. It's open to the church. However, I want to make sure that ministry leaders and officers, please make sure that you are especially in attendance as we're trying to get ready for our church conference that's coming up soon. Amen. Amen, amen. Well, also, if you had checked your email, you know that we have an event coming up September the 22nd, promoted by the Adult Ministries. They're having another information session sponsored by the County Register of Wills. It's entitled The Last Step of Putting Your Loved One Away. And all these info sessions that we've been having been very, very valuable. I have to stress again, you don't know you need it until you need it. Come on, somebody. And it's best to try to be proactive than reactive. Being proactive takes a whole lot of stress off of your shoulders. I see it. I sit in the office and I meet with people every time somebody's passing away. And I can tell those that are prepared versus those that are not prepared. So church family, for our family online, take advantage of this. September the 22nd at 7:00. The information is in your email. For those of you that don't get emails, please reach out to the church and we'll let you know how to get involved in that and participate. I also put it on the website, so make sure that you do that. If you have any information or you need additional information, please see Sister Sharon Cager. There she is. Sharon Cager Best. She's the coordinator for Adult Ministries. Amen, somebody. Amen, amen. Lastly, I just want to mention again about our weekly Bible studies. Mondays, the men have it at 6:30. On Wednesdays, young adults at 6:30. And GPS, led by me, at 7:00. And Thursday mornings with the pastor at 11 a.m. So if you want to join us, we invite you to, again, just contact the church, and then we'll make sure that you get everything that you need to be a part. I certainly don't want to leave out Wednesday morning prayer. The men just primed the pump. They said, have a little talk with Jesus. Come on, somebody, and he'll make it all right. And we do every Wednesday morning at 8:00, and we invite you to join us. You might say, well, I'm on my way to work. It's okay, because at 8:00, you're going to be muted. Amen. And so you can do the hearing while you're on your way to work. Billy Graham quoted, in the morning, prayer is the key that opens us to the treasures of God's mercy and his blessing. And in the evening, it's the key that shuts us up under his protection and safeguard. Amen. Amen. So make sure that you join us 8:00. It's just for a few minutes, and then you can start the rest of the week having your spiritual tank filled. Amen. Amen. And this concludes the announcements for this morning. You all have a blessed day in the Lord. Amen.
Greetings, Asbury Town Neck family and friends. Welcome to the ATN Network. Luke chapter 6, verse 38 reads, give, and it will be given to you, a good measure, pressed down, shaken together, and running over. will be poured into your lap. For with the measure you use it, it will be measured to you. Therefore know, God takes whatever we give and multiplies it so that we can be blessed to be a blessing. Brothers and sisters, currently we have four ways to give. You can call 410-647-3461 to arrange an in-person drop-off. You can mail your tithes and your offerings to 429 Asbury Drive, Severna Park, Maryland, 21146. Or you can visit our website, asburytownnet.org, and click the donate button. Or you can use the Cash App at $ATNUMC. Thank you for your continual support of the ministries of Asbury Townnet United Methodist Church. We invite you to continue to join us for worship and the Word.
Good morning, church. Good morning. It's good to see you all today. All right, so I'll be reading Luke chapter 15, verses 1 through 10. When you find it, please stand. Now the tax collectors and the sinners were all gathered around to hear Jesus. But the Pharisees and the teachers of the law muttered, "This man welcomes sinners and eats with them." Then Jesus told them this parable. Suppose one of you has 100 sheep and loses one of them. Doesn't he leave the 99 in the open country and go after the lost sheep until he finds it? And when he finds it, he joyfully puts it on his shoulders and goes home. Then he calls his friends and neighbors together and says, "Rejoice with me. I have found my lost sheep." I tell you that in the same way, there will be more rejoicing in heaven over one sinner who repents than over the 99 righteous people who do not need to repent. Or suppose a woman who has 10 silver coins and loses one. Doesn't she light a lamp, sweep the house, and search carefully until she finds it? And when she finds it, she calls her friends and neighbors, and together she says, "Rejoice with me, I have found my lost coin." In the same way, I tell you, there is rejoicing in the presence of the angels of God over one sinner who repents. May the Lord add a blessing to the reading of this word. Amen. You may be seated.
Give God glory for the word. Hallelujah. I like that. This is one of those songs that my grandmother used to say. Songs that got us over. One of those songs that lets you know that your face danger. I don't know what you come to do this morning, but I dare somebody to praise the Lord. Hallelujah. God is God. He won't change. Whoa. No, he won't
change.
I'll say that again. God is God, and he won't
change.
My Lord.
Oh, God,
and he won't change. He can do again.
What he did before.
anybody ever been sick? Listen. God is a doctor and he won't.
Change.
No, he won't. Anybody ever been in trouble? Listen. God is a lawyer and he won't
change.
Oh, my Lord.
Oh, God is a lawyer and he won't change.
Yeah. I got one more for you. My God is a provider and he won't want to make a way for you.
Oh, God is a provider.
He's a provider.
And he won't change.
Well, he won't change.
He won't change.
No, he won't.
He won't change.
He won't change.
He won't change.
No, he won't.
He won't change.
He'll always stay the same.
He won't.
God's the same yesterday and today. He won't ever change. No matter what you're going through, no matter what your situation looks like, you can lean on him because he won't change. Come on, fellas, take it up. He won't change.
He won't change.
I found out for myself.
He won't change.
And no matter what it looks like,
he won't change.
To praise him. Hallelujah. Come on, give God glory. He won't ever change. You can always come back home. You just gotta look to the hills from which cometh your help. God is an ever-present presence. Hallelujah. Give God glory.
Hallelujah. Our God, he won't change. Our God, he won't change. He's the God that changes not. And God, we thank you that you are our ever-present help in the time of trouble. And God, we thank you that you don't change being our Savior, being our Redeemer, being the one who comes in and brings peace in the midst of chaos. God, we thank you that you don't change any of that. So will you pray with me this morning? Oh, Lord, our God, how excellent is your name in all the earth. God, we thank you that you are the God who is a provider who doesn't change. You're the God who's a healer and doesn't change. You're a God who's a Savior and a Redeemer and doesn't change. And so, God, this day, we ask that you would just come in and continue to inhabit the praises of your people. God, today I pray that as we talk about finding the lost ones, oh God, God, that you would just hide me behind your rugged cross and allow the Galilean preacher named Jesus to show up instead of me. Have your way, Holy Spirit, even now. In the name of the Father, Son, and Spirit, we pray. Let the people of God say amen, amen, and amen. Our brothers and sisters, this week marked another time in history where nations will remember where they were when they heard the news. If you don't know what I'm talking about, Queen Elizabeth II, the longest living monarch, died this week at the age of 96. In the history of Great Britain, people remember where they were when Edward VIII abdicated the throne. That's when he gave up the throne and went on and married someone and just kind of messed up the whole situation. They remember where they were when Winston Churchill died. And for most of the world, they remember where they were when they heard that the beloved humanitarian Princess Diana died. In U.S. history, we remember the news when the bombs came down on Pearl Harbor, and we remember that. We remember where we were when both the Kennedy brothers, both President John F. Kennedy and Bobby Kennedy, died. We remember where we were when the news came that Martin Luther King was assassinated. And on today, 21 years later, on the anniversary of September 11th, we still remember where we were when 19 militant extremists hijacked four planes, crashed into two World Trade Center towers in New York, the Pentagon in Arlington, and a field in Pennsylvania. These attacks took the lives of almost 3,000 people. We remember where we were. And out of those buried in the rubble of the World Trade Center, there were only 20 that survived. There was a movie that came out in about 2006 about two of the firefighters who made it. They were numbers 18 and 19. And the story kind of went about how a Marine just decided that he was just going to come and dig through the rubble and see who he could find. And he heard them making noises. He heard his voices. He heard them banging on pipes and whatnot so that they could hear him. And he said, "Don't worry, the Marines are here, and we don't leave anybody behind," right? And so we hear the story of these two men. But did you know number 20 was a black woman? We don't know her story. Her name was Janelle Guzman McMillan, and she was buried under the rubble for 27 hours. She said she could barely talk because of the dust and debris, and she all she could do was hold on because she had a daughter, and she wanted to make sure she saw her daughter again, and then she began to pray. And at that point where she was like, "God, I don't think I have anything left," she heard a voice that somebody was coming to get her. This morning, I want to talk a little bit about just finding the lost ones. Because on September 11th, I think about these 20 that were buried in the rubble and how it took hours and hours to get them out. Because now all we see are these beautiful monuments to what happened
in the various places. We see the silvery platforms that's in the Pentagon. We see what's at Ground Zero in New York. We see the monuments, but it just seems like as 21 years have gone, we forget the rubble. We forget that there were some people who just got down and dug and just continued to use their hands. They used whatever they had to get to these 20 people and try to see if there was anybody left. And so I just think it's so important that we just kind of have that thought in our mind of sometimes finding the lost ones takes effort. Finding the lost ones takes a willingness just to know that there is somebody there who needs to hear your voice and hear a word that you are going to make it. When we enter into our text this morning, we enter into a time where Jesus is just kind of doing what Jesus does. He's meeting with tax collectors and sinners, and the Pharisees and the teachers of the law, the Sadducees, were having some issues with the fact that Jesus decided to hang out with some lost people, some people who just lost their way, some people who are not living to the letter of the law, some people that were just trying to figure out what do I do? How do I survive in this lifestyle? How do I get connected back to the God of my salvation? And Jesus was like, I'm gonna go talk to them. I'm gonna go and talk to the ones who are lost and who really need to be reminded who they are and why God created them and remind them that there is a God who wants to forgive and wants to be reconnected, who wants them to have a divine relationship and encounter. So I'm gonna go and find them folk. But the Pharisees and Sadducees had something to say about that. They says, this man welcomes sinners and he eats with them. A part of our table fellowship whenever we have communion is the fact that we eat with one another, both sinners and saints alike. It's a reminder that there is a God who continues to invite us to his table to taste and see that God is good, that his mercies endure forever, and that his table is welcome to anybody who's just looking to be found. Then Jesus decides to give these two parables. And you remember, parables are just simply stories that have a moral meaning. And he's trying to get them to understand something. And he uses their terms of the day. And it's not uncommon to hear about shepherd and sheep. And because guess what? They're part of this type of community that are wanderers, that they have some shepherds, they have some sheep, they have some goats, they have some animals. And so he tells them this story. He says, suppose one of you has 100 sheep and loses one of them. Doesn't he go and leave the 99 in the open country and go after the lost sheep until he finds it? Wait a minute. Doesn't he go and find the one, just one? Don't you know that a shepherd, not his staff is not just to beat off the wolves. Their staff is also to gather the lost, to pull them in just a little bit closer. And then he says, well, don't the people rejoice that I have found my lost sheep? He says, I tell you that in the same way that there will be more rejoicing in heaven over one sinner who repents than over 99 righteous people who do not need to repent. He's reminding them, look, none of us are perfect. And we need to be rejoicing and celebrating when there is one who decides, guess what? I don't got it all together, but I know someone who does. And I'm going to introduce you to this one. And where something is going to happen once you receive, hallelujah, salvation from God. There is rejoicing. And that is what the community of faith is all about. I love the second parable. Or suppose a woman who has 10 silver coins. Some translation says drachmas, which is each silver coin is worth one day's labor. Suppose she loses one and she sweeps the house and she searches carefully until she finds it. And don't we rejoice when she has found a lost coin? Don't we rejoice that she has found what she needed to survive? Don't we rejoice when God does something new? But I just want to, can I get a little real with us on Sunday morning? Sometimes we don't rejoice after somebody has been lost and have come back to church. Sometimes we want to be accusatory because we ain't seen them for a while. We wonder where they've been at, why they ain't show up, instead of just saying, guess what? Welcome home. I'm so excited to see you. I am so excited to see you, and I am rejoicing that God has brought you home. Can we go there this morning? There's a book by a pastor. His name is Adam Hamilton. It's called When Christians Get It Wrong. And he talks about these things, about some challenges for why young people don't want to be involved in church. Can we go there this morning? All right. These are some challenges he lays out. He says, you know, number one, folk act unchristian. So they don't want to, and this is not just for young people, this is just for people that haven't been involved in church for a bit. One of the barriers is that they encounter folk that say they're Christians who act unchristian. So why do I want to come and be a part of a community where they're not acting like what they say they are? All right, we're going to tell the truth this morning. Number two, he says that they don't engage in science or politics. I'm just going to make it plain. We don't engage enough in social justice issues. I'm just going to break it down for us. We are part of the Baltimore Washington Conference of United Methodist Church. We are near D.C. We are 6 miles from Annapolis. We are right in the center of policy making and where decisions are being made. We have a responsibility to be involved in social justice and social action. Part of the barriers of why folk don't want to get involved in church is because we're not talking about issues of social justice and social action and how to participate in that part of the life of the community. But hello, I'm gonna call out Sharon. We have a great resource in here, Sister Sharon. Sharon is always trying to bring in different things for us to get involved. We have hosted voting. We had a voting site at our church. We are trying to be involved in the social justice process, y'all. Another barrier that comes up that makes people continue to be lost and not want to come back into the fold is that we don't want to talk about other religions. Or if we do talk about other religions, it's always in a negative light. But there are some folk that want to be in community and relationship with us. They may not believe what we believe, but they may have a similar vision, meaning that they want to empower the poor. They want to make sure people have resources. And we can be in connection and community just because folk don't believe what we believe. That don't mean we can't be loving and gracious towards them. These are all barriers that come up in making sure that people continue to be lost. We don't say anything when bad things happen. We don't say anything, or we give trite sayings when bad things happen, meaning that we're trying to be comforting, but we don't know what to say, so we make up something. Come on now. Versus just saying, you know what, I don't know, but there's a God who knows better than us. Can we be honest about that this morning? Sometimes we just got to be willing to say, you know what, I don't have the answer to this. But we can pray and ask God to send us the answer. And even if he doesn't answer in the ways in which we wanted to answer, at least we brought our concern to God. Now, this is a little touchy. And this is also a reason why there's a little bit of a split that has happened in the United Methodist Church, is that we don't want to deal with issues around LGBTQIA+ people. And everybody has their viewpoint of where you stand on that issue. I'm not going to convince you one way or the other, but there, because of non-hospitable practices to this community, that is also a barrier oftentimes to people participating in the life of the church. I'm just laying it out. You can agree or disagree. I'm just laying it out for you. This is why folks stay lost. This is why folk don't want to be found. This is why folk are trying to figure out, do I want to come back to church at all? these reasons. These are some of the reasons. Some, again, I always bring up sometimes folk have past trauma. And I just want to bring something up because I think this is a real conversation for us to have. I know I'm just doing a little talking today, but I just feel like God just wants me to let y'all know. Sometimes we just have to be willing not to give up on our young folk or folk that haven't been involved, be it, you know, and they may be older folk and stuff have happened. Don't give up on them. But can I get a little personal? I'm gonna get a little personal. This may not be their church. We may want them to come back to this church, but this may not be where God wants them to be. But it's our job to lead them to a place where they can be. Let me say that again. This may not be their church. And we want it to be their church. We want to be a welcoming and open, hospitable church. We want folk to just come and experience the love, grace, and mercy of God. We want them to hear a word from God. We want them to be encouraged. But this may not be the place for them. But there are other places that are for them. And we got to encourage them to get to a place and help them to find their place. And for those that are online, amen, yeah. We got to help them find their place. And if it's their place to be online for a season, because sometimes folk need to be online for a season to see what's happening, see what's going on before they come back in. Let them know it's okay to be online for a season. It's all right. Are you participating? Are you actively watching? Are you sowing into the ministry of the church? Are you trying to figure out how to get involved in Bible study? If mission opportunities come available, are you willing to serve? These things say that they want to participate in the life of the church, and that's a good thing, y'all. Part of being the body of Christ is that we rejoice when someone who is lost is now found. But we also have to make the decision not to be a barrier to the lost ones. Can we say that this morning? Can we make some commitments this morning that we're going to do whatever we can to be open, welcoming, loving, and affirming and not be a barrier to somebody trying to get to know God? Now, I got a couple yeses, but I'm gonna wait a second because I think that's so important. Can we make a commitment to not be a barrier to somebody encountering Jesus? Come on. Can we make a commitment? Can we work on being judgmental? Can we work on talking about how to get involved in social justice issues? Can we work on being in relationship with brothers and sisters of different faiths? Can we work on being encouraging and supportive when bad things happen? Can we work on just saying, I don't care who you love, you can come to church because the church is open for you? Can we just get to a place where we just say, look, God just wants you to be found. God wants you to be loved. God wants you to be affirmed. God wants you to know that there is somebody who cares about you, who wants you to be saved, who wants you to have a relationship with Christ. There is somebody who just wants you to be healed and whole and come on to Jesus. We talked about how we serve a God who changes not. We serve a God who says, taste and see. We serve a God who says, I love you in spite of you. We serve a God who ate with tax collectors and sinners. We serve a God who was with those who did not have it all together. We serve a God who says, guess what? I didn't come for the righteous. I came for those who are sick. And we serve a God who says, you were once lost, but now you are found. We serve a God who says, I'm going to leave the 99 and go after you, the one, because guess what? The one, you are worth it. You are worth it. I don't know who needs to hear it this morning, but you are worth God going and seeking and finding you and bringing you back into his loving arms of protection and salvation and healing. You are worth it. We serve a God who continues to go after the lost. This is how I know on this anniversary of 9/11, 21 years later, we have first responders who have had health issues from digging folk out, be it cancer, be it other issues of just working the pile, working the rubble, and their families have suffered. It has taken 21 years for New York to pass legislation for compensation for these families. So we serve a God. We serve a God who continues to go after the lost, to take care of them, to love them, to remind them that God sees, God hears, God loves. So this morning, you may be lost, or maybe you're praying for somebody who's lost. Maybe you may not know their name, but you've been praying for just people who don't believe in Jesus, folk that have lost their way. This morning, I just invite you to pray with me. If you don't know Jesus and the pardon of your sins and you would like to know him today, will you raise your hand in the sanctuary and we will pray with you? Will you let us know online? You can do a thumbs up. You can raise your hand online and we want to acknowledge you wherever you are. If you are lost and you are asking God to find you. Lord God, we pray for those who may not know you yet, but who are wandering and just need a reminder that there is a God who loves and sees and affirms. So God, I just pray on today that you will tell the lost ones that hear the word, come to me all who are weary and heavy laden and I will give you rest. And so God, I pray against the weariness of those who are lost. God, this morning, I pray for those who may want to rededicate their life to Jesus Christ. Maybe they've been going left and it's time to go right. Maybe they've been a part of the community of faith by attending but haven't really been a part because they might have been to church but God wasn't in them. And so, God, I pray that you will just fill them with your Holy Spirit on today. That you will remind them that the same Spirit that's in Christ Jesus is also in them. And so, God, I pray that you would empower them. God, on today, I pray for those who are just in need of special prayers. It may be a health thing. We lift up Latoya and Miss Barbara this morning, and we ask that you would heal their bodies, oh God, that you would touch them from the top of their head to the bottom of their feet, Lord, and that you would strengthen their innermost being. God, we pray for the family of Betty Grimes this morning, and we just ask that you will show up as the divine comforter. God, we pray for those who are unemployed or underemployed, oh God. And Lord, we just ask in the name of Jesus that every need will be supplied according to your riches and glory. God, we pray for those who are passionless. And I say that because some folk have been going to a job and doing something year after year, day after day that they just have no passion for. And so, God, I just pray that you would align people with their passion and their purpose and their calling today. God, I pray for those that are just in need of a loving touch from you because they have been hurt and abused by the world. And so, God, I'm just praying that you would find them and just remind them that there is a God who cares. Lord Jesus, today I just pray that you would strengthen us, that you will guide us, that you will protect us, and that you'll remind us that we are your own. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, we pray. Amen and amen. Will you stand on your feet if you're able at this time? And I'm going to invite the Johnson Male Chorus up. Amen, amen. I invite you to raise one hand, two hands unto God. We're going to do the benediction. And after the benediction, it'll be followed by one more selection by the Johnson Male Chorus. Again, as we raise our hands, one or two. And if you're online, you can raise your hand as well. As we raise our hands, this is a position of surrender. It's also a position of receiving. And so, God, we ask that you would bless us, that you will continue to invite us into your presence, into your care. Remind us, oh God, that you have called each and every one of us to be in relationship and fellowship with you. And God, on today, we rejoice over the lost who have come back home. We rejoice in the ones that are coming, that we are expecting to show up. We rejoice, oh God, that this is a place for those who just have lost their way and can now find a place to call home. So God, we pray that this is home for somebody. We pray that this would be a home for whoever is lost and broken, that they might encounter a loving and healing God in this place. So God, help us to be the righteous that rejoice. In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, we pray, amen and amen. We love you, family. There's nothing you can do about it. We pray that you have a wonderful week. And we turn it over to the Johnson Male Chorus as they continue to sing the songs of Zion and invite us into a loving relationship with Christ. Amen and amen.
Times that will stand the test, even when we've done our best. Oh Lord,
oh Lord,
yes Lord,
oh Lord,
Lord, stand,
Lord
by me.
Stand by me.
Now if you don't know the Lord in the pardons of your sins, oh Lord,
oh Lord,
yes Lord,
Lord, stand by me.
Well, just open up your heart and let Jesus just walk on in.
Oh Lord,
yes Lord,
Lord,
stand by me.
Help me drink this bitter cup.
Oh Lord,
oh Lord,
oh Lord,
oh Lord,
Lord, stand,
Lord
by me.
Stand by me.
Now when everything goes wrong and there's troubles all in your arms,
oh Lord,
oh Lord,
oh Lord,
Lord, stand by me. I don't worry, I don't fret, because God has never failed me yet.
Oh Lord,
yes Lord,
oh
Lord, stand by me.
Oh Lord,
oh Lord,
stand by me.
While I walk,
yes, this lonesome
road.
Help me drink this bitter cup.
Oh Lord,
oh Lord,
oh Lord,
oh Lord,
Lord, stand by
Lord,
me.
Stand by me.
Oh my Lord,
oh Lord, stand by me.
While I walk
this lonesome road.
Oh Lord,
oh Lord, stand by me.
Help me bear
this heavy load.
If I stumble,
Lord, pick me up.
Help me drink.
Help me drink
Oh Lord, oh Lord, oh Lord, oh Lord, oh Lord, oh Lord, Lord, stand by me. Help me drink.
Help me drink this bitter cup.
Oh Lord.
Oh Lord.
Oh Lord.
Oh Lord.
Oh Lord.
For a saint is just a sinner who